राइट फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू 19th वीक. फ्रॉम 4th टू 10th मे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इंपॉर्टेंट इवेंट्स ऑफ द वीक. एंड फर्स्ट एंड द फॉरमोस्ट इवेंट इज प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया प्रणब मुखर्जीस विजिट टू रशिया. मैसिव विक्टरी डे सेलिब्रेशंस इन रशिया एज वेल एज अक्रॉस यूरोप विच कमेमोरेट्स द विक्टरी ऑफ अलाइड फोर्सेस इन सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर. The launching of Pradhanmantri Jeevan Jyoti Bhima Yojana, Pradhanmantri Suraksha Bhima Yojana and Atal Pension Yojana by the Prime Minister in Kolkata in the presence of West Bengal Chief Minister. Passage of historic or land boundary agreement between India and Bangladesh. Prime Minister's visit to Naxal infected area Dantewada in Chhattisgarh. Inauguration of ISCO steel plant. One more important event, international event, is the victory of Conservative Party in Britain. Look at the other events. The FIR against Madhya Pradesh Governor was quashed by Madhya Pradesh High Court. Stressed assets are increasing, as stated by Reserve Bank of India. The population of Asiatic lions increased and Liberia is declared Ebola free. These are the important events of the week, and we are going to discuss issue by issue in clear terms. Right, friends? Look at the first and the foremost event, President of India's visit to Russia. We very well know the constitutional head of the state is the president, executive head of the state is the prime minister, and the constitutional head, the president of the country, visited Russia. And last week there were major celebrations across Europe as well as Russia. What is Victory in Europe Day? Victory Day is the day which is being celebrated every year on May 8th across Europe, and on May 9th in Russia, May 8th across Europe and May 9th in Russia, to commemorate the victory of Allied forces over Germany in the Second World War. The Second World War between 1939 and 1945. First, Germany surrendered in the year 1945 on May 8th. A week prior to that, Adolf Hitler committed suicide, and Germany surrendered on 8th May. And to commemorate that day, Victory in Europe Day or VE Day is celebrated across Europe on May 8th, and on May 9th, Victory Day is celebrated in Russia because of the time difference. And the President Pranab Mukherjee attended Victory Day celebrations in Russia. This year, Victory Day celebrations in Russia were done in massive scale. Around 20 to 25 heads of state participated, but the conspicuous absentees are most of the Western countries, because Western countries are not happy with the annexation of Crimea by Russia. Crimea was previously part of Ukraine, and last year referendum was held. Crimea was annexed by Russia, but the Western world is not recognizing this, and Western countries say that this referendum was done under the heavy presence of Russian forces. That's why the referendum was not fair in the words of Western world, and subsequently Western countries imposed sanctions against Russia. several Western countries not participated in the Victory Day celebrations of Russia. But the president of China, Xi Jinping, as well as Indian president, president of Kazakhstan, that means around 20 to 25 world leaders, but without Western leaders, participated in Victory Day celebrations in Russia. This year is the 70th year of Victory Day celebrations, which marks the 70th year of victory of Allied forces in Second World War over Germany. And here the Indian contingent of 75 members strong, led by Captain Vikash Singh Sohag. And please don't forget, Chinese contingent participated for the first time in the Victory Day celebrations. Chinese contingent participated for the first time in the Victory Day celebrations. And this shows Russia and China becoming closer. Russia and China becoming closer, and India played its cards diplomatically by sending the constitutional head to participate in Victory Day celebrations. That means India wants to maintain strategic relationship with the developed economies of the world. So here I would like to tell you a few more points. First and the foremost is, in the Victory Day celebrations, Chinese troops or People's Liberation Army participated for the first time. 20 to 25 countries participated in the Victory Day celebrations. And please look into the other aspects of the president's visit, president being the constitutional head. Not many agreements are expected, but the president of India inaugurated cultural exchange program, which is known as Namaste Russia, to showcase India's culture in Russia. It will be there for 6 months period across Russia. So the visit of president of India to Russia is basically to have presence in Victory Day celebrations, right? Please look into the next issue. India-Bangladesh land boundary agreement. This is the historic agreement. Parliament passed 119th Constitutional Amendment Bill. Both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha passed almost unanimously. 119th Constitutional Amendment Bill was passed. And as this involves changes in the constitutional provisions, requires the ratification by 50% of the state legislatures. So this constitutional amendment bill is to be ratified by 50% of the state legislatures, and subsequently this will become 100th Constitutional Amendment Act. Right? What exactly is this land boundary agreement? All of us are well aware, Pakistan got its independence in the year 1947, like India in those days. The present day Pakistan was known as West Pakistan, and the present day Bangladesh was known as East Pakistan. Let me tell you once again, the present day Pakistan was known as West Pakistan. The present day Bangladesh was known as East Pakistan, and East Pakistan became Bangladesh in the year 1971. In the year 1971, East Pakistan became Bangladesh. And you all well aware, Radcliffe Line separates India and Pakistan. Radcliffe Line separates India and Pakistan, as well as India and Bangladesh. Right? But there are some enclaves. Please look into this picture. You are very clear. Let us assume this as the boundary line. On this side, India, that side Bangladesh. It is only just to understand what is enclave. You see, there are some Indian enclaves in Bangladeshi territory surrounded by Bangladeshi land. There are some Indian enclaves in Bangladesh territory surrounded by Bangladesh land. Similarly, there are some Bangladeshi enclaves in Indian territory surrounded by Indian territory. There are some Indian enclaves in Bangladesh surrounded by Bangladesh territory. There are some Bangladeshi enclaves in Indian territory surrounded by Indian territory. That means, for the enclaves in Bangladesh territory, if India wants to govern, they have to cross Bangladesh to reach that enclave. Similarly, if Bangladesh wants to ensure governance in these territories, they have to cross India to reach these territories. The two territories are given in different colors. Please look into this picture. The territory is close to green, India, and the territory is close to red color or Bangladeshi territories. Because of this problem, the territories are popularly known as enclaves are not being governed for the past 50 to 60 years. That means there is no governance in these enclaves for the past several years. The people don't have statutory rights. They don't have citizenship of any country. Under these circumstances, this land boundary agreement assumes significance. And please look into the picture. The territories or the enclaves enclosed in the Indian territory will be transferred to India. And the enclaves, Indian enclaves in Bangladesh territory will be transferred to Bangladesh. Why this could not be done for the past several years? Why this could not be done for the past several years? There were two reasons. First and the foremost reason is, Indian enclaves are more in number and area is more by around 10,000 acres. Indian enclaves are more in number towards Bangladesh side, and if this land boundary agreement is implemented, India will lose around 10,000 acres more land to Bangladesh. That was one reason. The second reason is, if this agreement is settled or if we transfer some enclaves to Bangladesh with this type of agreement, till date government feared that there may be some agitations across the country asking for similar arrangement, or there may be secessionist agitations in some parts of the country. Because of that, because of these two reasons, one reason is India's area is more. India will lose 10,000 acres. The second thing is, if this agreement is ratified, it may lead to such type of agitations in some parts of the country. Government feared it. That's why till date it could not be implemented. Now Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha passed it because it alters the boundaries. That's why it requires constitutional amendment, and 50% of the state legislatures are to ratify this. There are 29 states in the country. 15 state legislatures have to ratify it. Once 15 state legislatures ratify this, then this will become 100th Constitutional Amendment Act, and the Indian enclaves towards Bangladesh side will be transferred to Bangladesh. Bangladeshi enclaves towards Indian side will be transferred to India. Then they will have citizenship rights. They will have facilities. They will have access to all statutory facilities being given by Bangladesh as well as India. Right, friends? This is all about a land boundary agreement. It is a historic agreement. And let us look into the next issue. Prime Minister launched Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bhima Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bhima Yojana and Atal Pension Yojana in Kolkata. In the presence of the Chief Minister of West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee. And this program was launched across the country at 115 centers. Government wants to give big push for this Jan Suraksha. That means life insurance, accident insurance and pension. Government wants to kickstart these programs. So that's why This was started at around 115 centers across the country, and this was opened by the Prime Minister in Kolkata, and at the same time the Finance Minister opened in Mumbai and the Home Minister Rajnath Singh in Lucknow, and several chief ministers, governors, cabinet ministers participated across the country, and the government wants to kickstart these programs in a big way. And we have already discussed about the salient features of these programs in separate series called Policies and Programs of the Government of India. Right? Please look into the next issue. PM's visit to Dantewada, Chhattisgarh, Naxal infected area. Dantewada is situated in Bastar region of Chhattisgarh. 4 MOUs were signed near Dantewada. This is famous for iron ore mines, properly known as the Bailadila iron ore mines. And 4 MOUs were signed, and Prime Minister led foundation stone for 2 important projects. One important project is for setting up of ultra mega steel plant at Dilmili in Bastar region. Ultra mega steel plant at Dilmili in Bastar region. The second important is foundation stone for new railway line between Rauhghat and Jagdalpur. Foundation stone for around 140 kilometers of railway line between Jagdalpur and Rauhghat. And once this railway line is completed, Jagdalpur, which is in the Bastar region, will have direct connection to Raipur, the state capital. The Prime Minister laid the foundation stone for these 2 programs. Right, friends, look into the next issue. Prime Minister inaugurates an augmented ISCO plant. What is ISCO plant? Indian Iron and Steel Company. Indian Iron and Steel Company. This is the second steel plant started in the country after Tata Iron and Steel Company. First steel plant in India, Tata Iron and Steel Company. This is Indian Iron and Steel Company. This is the second steel plant established in private sector in the year 1918 at a place called Burnpur. Burnpur is close to Asansol in West Bengal. This place is on the banks of river Damodar, and subsequently government nationalized this steel plant in the year 1972, and later on it became the 5th steel plant under SAIL. SAIL is the Steel Authority of India Limited. This is the 5th steel plant under SAIL. The remaining 4, you all well aware, Bhilai in Chhattisgarh, Bokaro in Jharkhand, Rourkela in Odisha, Durgapur in West Bengal, and this is the 5th integrated steel plant under SAIL, and this is at a place called Burnpur near Asansol. And please don't forget this area, Durgapur, already integrated steel plant is there. Near Durgapur, a place called Andal, first private international airport is coming up. And nearer to it, Asansol, famous for coal mines. And around 7-8 kilometers from that, this ISCO is situated. So this entire belt, that is Durgapur, Andal, Asansol, Burnpur, this entire belt, there is every likelihood that this may become the industrial hub of West Bengal in future. It is situated near to Damodar River. Before going into the next event, I would like to tell you 2 things. This ISCO plant was modernized at a cost of rupees 16,000 crores. And it is augmented from 0.85 million tons per annum to 2.9 million tons per annum. 0.85 million tons per annum to 2.9 million tons per annum. Other important aspect is this has got country's largest blast furnace, that is the Kalyani. The country's largest blast furnace. What is blast furnace? Blast furnace is ore will be dropped into the blast furnace. Hot air will be blown from below, and subsequently that molten metal will come out along with the slag and hot gases will go away. That means separating impurities from iron ore to get the molten metal, that is blast furnace. Separating impurities and undesirable things from iron ore to get the molten metal, that is the purpose of blast furnace. And the country's largest blast furnace, Kalyani, is inaugurated by the Prime Minister at ISCO plant at Burnpur near Asansol. Please don't forget. Look into the next issue. Government of India clarifies that there is no plan for creation of separate zones for Pandits in Kashmir. Because of the disturbances, Kashmiri Pandits migrated around 20 to 25 years ago from Kashmir, and they are staying at several places in the country. And they settled at the faraway places like Delhi, Jammu and other places. Government recently stated that they will create separate zones for Kashmiri Pandits. And now the government says there is no plan for creation of separate zones. After a lot of hesitation, government backtracked on the proposal. And what is the difference between internally displaced persons and refugees? Internally displaced persons, IDPs, the example is Kashmiri Pandits. They are displaced from their homeland Kashmir and they settled in various parts of the country. They are called internally displaced persons. But if people are displaced from their mainland and settled in some other countries, they are called refugees. If people displaced from their homeland and settled in other countries, they are called refugees. You all well aware, several Afghan refugees are in Pakistan. Several Syrian refugees are in Turkey. So they are refugees. If they cross boundaries of the nation, they are refugees. If they are displaced internally, they are called internally displaced persons or IDPs. Kashmiri Pandits are examples for IDPs. Right, look into the next one. NJSC validity standoff continues between 5-judge bench and Attorney General. Arguments, counter arguments are going on about NJSC validity. Government's viewpoint is being put forward by the Attorney General Mukul Rohtagi, and the validity of NJSC. 5-judge bench is hearing the petitions filed against the validity of NJSC. Arguments and counter arguments. Mukul Rohtagi says, collegium system for appointment of judges, which is in vogue since 1993, is not as per the constitution. But the 5-judge bench posed a counter why the government has not opposed in 1993. Why are you silent for the past 20 years? Why are you questioning the validity of collegium system now? Like that, arguments, counter arguments are going on with regard to the validity of NJSC, and this will continue for some more time. Please look into the next issue. 122nd constitutional amendment bill to facilitate introduction of goods and services tax passed by Lok Sabha. This goods and services tax, it integrates all types of indirect taxes in the country. What is the goods and services tax? It integrates all the indirect taxes imposed by center as well as the states. What are the taxes imposed by center? It is excise duty, service tax, the taxes imposed by states, entertainment tax, octroi duty, entry tax. And once this GST is implemented, the integration of all the indirect taxes will take place. And Lok Sabha passed this bill because of the majority of BJP in Lok Sabha, and Rajya Sabha is yet to pass this bill. Instead, Rajya Sabha referred this bill to the select committee of Rajya Sabha for verification clause by clause. Lok Sabha passed this bill, Rajya Sabha is yet to pass the bill. Right friends, look into the next issue. Salman Khan sentenced to 5 years of imprisonment after 12 years. The case pertains to 2002. On the night of September 27th, his car was driven over 5 persons sleeping on the pavement. One person lost his life. After 12 to 13 years, the Sessions Court found Salman Khan guilty and imposed 5 years rigorous imprisonment and 25,000 rupees as fine, because the Sessions Court felt that he was driving without license and he was driving in inebriated condition. Because of these two reasons, 5 years rigorous imprisonment was imposed with 25,000 rupees as fine, but subsequently Bombay High Court granted the bail and suspended the 5 year sentence. Right, friends, look into the next one. Amendments to Juvenile Justice Act cleared by Lok Sabha, but it is yet to be passed by Rajya Sabha. I have already told you in previous classes, juveniles are up to the age of 18 years. Whatever the crime they commit, till date, the maximum punishment is just 3 years. Once this bill is passed, then in the age group of 16 to 18 years, in the age group of 16 and 18 years, if they commit a heinous crime, they can be tried as adults. At present, the maximum punishment is only 3 years. But once this bill is passed, in the age group of 16 and 18 years, if they commit heinous crimes, they can be tried as adults. But Rajya Sabha is yet to pass this bill. Please look into the next issue. Important events, important world event, elections to UK Parliament. Several opinion polls predicted that there will be a seesaw battle between Conservative Party and Labour Party. But Conservative Party got a decisive victory. The lower house for which the elections are held is known as the House of Commons. The lower house is House of Commons. Elections were held for this house. Upper house in United Kingdom is known as House of Lords. Please don't forget, upper house is House of Lords. Lower house is House of Commons. And elections were held for House of Commons. Elections were held for House of Commons. Total strength is 650. Out of 650, Conservative Party got 331 seats. It got a decisive victory, and David Cameron once again will become the Prime Minister of the country. And the Labour Party leader Ed Miliband resigned. And I would like to infer two things with regard to the election results. First and the foremost thing is, Conservative Party promised that they will hold referendum whether to stay with the European Union or not in the year 2017. Conservative Party stated that they will hold referendum in the year 2017 whether to stay with the European Union or not. And if the referendum is held in 2017 and people decide to go out of European Union, then it will have wider ramifications. The second important point is, SNP has got 56 seats out of 59 in Scotland region. Please don't forget, United Kingdom has got 4 regions. Please look into this picture. United Kingdom has got 4 regions. One is England, second one is Scotland, third one is Wales, fourth one is Northern Ireland. Please don't forget, United Kingdom has got 4 regions: England, Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland. The first 3 is known as Great Britain. The first 3, that means England, Scotland and Wales put together, is known as Great Britain. Great Britain along with Northern Ireland is known as United Kingdom. United Kingdom has got 4 regions, out of which Scotland is one. It has got 59 seats. SNP has got 56 seats out of 59. in Scotland region. And there is every possibility Scotland may press for referendum. Last year, referendum was held in Scotland. And they decided to stay with the United Kingdom. But there is every possibility they may press for fresh referendum in future. Right, friends? Look into the next issue. Holland, first Western head of state to attend a GCC meeting. What is GCC? GCC is Gulf Cooperation Council. There are six countries led by Saudi Arabia. The six countries you can see. It is a six-member bloc, friendly countries of Saudi Arabia. And the visit of France president to attend GCC meeting assumed significance because Saudi Arabia is leading airstrikes on Yemen. Because Saudi Arabia is leading airstrikes on Yemen and to extend the solidarity of Western world with Saudi Arabia. To extend solidarity of Western world with Saudi Arabia, the visit of France President Francois Hollande assumed the significance. And the other important aspect is this Rafale aircraft. Qatar purchased 24 aircraft after Egypt, India. Don't forget, India purchased last month 36 aircraft. Now Qatar purchased 24 more aircraft. Please look into the next issue. Army helicopter crashed in Pakistan. It crashed in the Gilgit-Baltistan region of Pak-occupied Kashmir. Several ambassadors were going to attend inauguration of some tourism project. But because of the crash of Mi-17 helicopter, two ambassadors of Philippines and Norway died. Initially, Pakistan Taliban claimed responsibility for the crash of the helicopter. But later on, the defense ministry officials stated that the helicopter crash was due to some technical snag. Anyhow, two ambassadors of Philippines and Norway lost their lives. Look into the next issue. In Delhi, citizens to pay environmental compensation for mileage say Nirmal Yamuna for Yamuna purification. National Green Tribunal recently gave orders that every household has to pay monthly environmental compensation directly proportional to their property tax or water bill, whichever is higher. Everyone have to pay monthly environmental compensation to purify Yamuna, because we are all responsible for the degradation of Yamuna river, because we are all discharging pollutants into the river, and to clean the river waters of Yamuna, National Green Tribunal ordered monthly environmental compensation. And for those unauthorized households with no water or property bills, compensation per month will be rupees 100 to rupees 500. At the same time, NGT also ordered, if someone throws municipal solid waste, they have to pay 5000 rupees fine. Right, friends? Look into the next one. FIR against Madhya Pradesh governor quashed by Madhya Pradesh High Court. Madhya Pradesh High Court recently stated, FIR against Madhya Pradesh governor is not tenable because he enjoys immunity while in office. As long as he is governor, he enjoys immunity. And as such, no one can file FIR as long as he is the governor. And the FIR already filed by SIT was quashed. You all well aware, an FIR was filed against Ram Naresh Yadav, governor of Madhya Pradesh, in Vyapam scam. We have already deliberated in the previous weeks. Look into the next one. when it comes to economy events, stressed assets in Indian banking system are on raise. Stressed assets means it is the total of gross non-performing assets. What is gross non-performing asset? When you take loan, you are not paying back to the bank for more than 90 days. You are required to pay back every month to bank, but you are not paying back. If you are not paying back to bank, which is known as servicing of the loan, if you are not servicing the loan for more than 90 days, it becomes a non-performing asset. Second thing is restructured assets. Banks will restructure certain loans because of some unforeseen situations. Banks will restructure some loans because of some unforeseen situations which are beyond the control of the person who took loan. So, these two put together, gross NPAs as well as restructured assets, these two put together are known as stressed assets. Stressed assets in the banking system are increasing. They are increased to 10.9% of total loans. And if you take only public sector banks, they are still higher at 13.2%. Right, friends? Future Retail and Bharti Retail decided to merge. You know about the Big Bazaar owned by Future Retail, as well as Easy Day owned by Bharti Retail. These two decided to merge, and you all very well know Kishore Biyani is the founder of Future Retail. Right, friends? Look into the next issue. Who declares Liberia Ebola free? Liberia is the West African country worst affected because of Ebola. Maximum deaths took place in Liberia because of Ebola. But now it is Ebola free when there is no case recorded for 42 days. It will be declared as Ebola free. When no new case is recorded for 42 days, why 42 days? 21 days is the incubation period of Ebola virus. What is incubation period? The period between your exposure to the infection. The period between your exposure to the infection and the symptoms of the disease. The period between your exposure to the infection and the symptoms of the disease. This gap is known as incubation period. Incubation period varies from disease to disease. Incubation period for common cold is hardly 2-3 days. Incubation period for smallpox may be 2 weeks. Incubation period for Ebola virus is 3 weeks or 21 days. That means, if you are exposed to Ebola infection, then it will take 21 days for the symptoms to be evident. It will take 21 days for the symptoms to be evident. So, when two incubation periods are passed without any new case, then it is declared as free of the disease. For this particular disease, 21 days is the incubation period. Now there is no case registered for 42 days. Hence it is declared as Ebola free. And Liberia, the worst affected country as far as Ebola is concerned, which accounted for maximum deaths, now Ebola free. But the neighboring countries, Sierra Leone and Guinea, are still struggling to contain the disease. This shows the effective action taken by Liberia in controlling the disease. Look into the last issue of this week. Asiatic lions in Gir forest increased. Gir forest is situated in Gujarat. predominantly situated in Junagadh and Amreli districts of Gujarat, and the population during the past 5 years increased from 411 to 523. There is an increase of 112. It's good news for the animal lovers, right? Let us conclude this lecture. Please do join for question and answer sessions. Have a nice day. Thank you.